Manifestation of your mercy.
Like the manifestation of your mercy.
Father, give my ministry
Lord,
value.
Give
Father,
my life my ministry value. Value.
Give my life mercy. Value for my house, value for my compound, value for my boys, value for my roads, value.
In the name of Jesus.
If a man, watch me very well, if a man will be anything to write home about, he said it will be a prelude of God's mercy. The race is not to the swift, the battle is to the captives. Are you there? Psalm 30 verse 10. Hear,
O Lord,
and have mercy upon me. Lord, be thou my helper. So when God's mercy comes on a man, he helps that man. When you say helper, it means there are certain things you can't do by yourself. Are you following me?
Yes, sir.
If man was enough for himself, there wouldn't have been need of Eve.
Yes.
And if Eve was enough for herself, there wouldn't have been need for Adam.
Yes.
If Jesus was enough for himself, there wouldn't have been need of the 12 disciples. I hope you're following me.
Yes, sir.
With all the promises that came upon Abraham, he gave birth to Isaac. With all the promises upon Isaac, Isaac had to get who?
Rebecca.
Abi?
Yes, sir.
Why? Because no one is enough. There's need for help.
Yes, sir.
But many times you run to people and these people are not able to ease you. Because it is not men you run to that matters. It's the mercy of God.
Yes, sir.
It is the mercy of God that gives you the right helper. When you say, oh Lord, have mercy upon me and be my helper. Many a times, it doesn't mean that God will come physically and help you. There are times that the power of God will help you to solve things out. But many a times, God will put men in place to give you necessary help. Even when you have the right people helping you, giving you the right help at the right time, it is a product of God's mercy. Do not think that your sharpness or your connections or your smartness did anything. If God's mercy is not there, then everything you try will fail. He says, have mercy. Hear, O Lord, have mercy upon me and be thou my helper. Lift your hands up. Father, I receive the mercy of help.
Father, I receive the mercy of help.
Pray for yourself.
The mercy of help.
I receive the mercy of help. Mercy for help.
Mercy for help.
Lord, show me mercy. Show me mercy. Be my helper. Be my helper. Be my helper. Show me mercy. Show me mercy. Help my life. Help me. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I told you that we're just going to pray about God's mercies today as we rounded up the teaching series yesterday. You're going to lift up your hand. Watch me. Watch me. Is there anywhere you have gotten to that you need divine help? Are you following me?
Yes, sir.
Is there anywhere you have gotten to and you just say, now what I need is the help of God. God has to help me. If God does not help me now, something will go wrong. One of my wife's friends was talking to her last week. She just gave birth. She lives in Lagos. She had her first children in Lagos, CS. She got the third pregnancy. She flew to the US to deliver. And she was telling my wife that the first 2 CS were done in Nigeria. She had a baby. But when she got to the US and they opened her up, they discovered that, is it the womb or something, was bleeding. That the old CS they did, where they sutured inside of her, still was bleeding. You can imagine that what just kills people. She had the first 2 CS in Nigeria successful, only for her to go and do the third one in the US, and the US doctor discovered that there is an error in the first one. One of the pastors that was there on Tuesday during the minister's conference, his wife had a CS in the hospital in Benin here, major hospital, government hospital. After the CS was done, long after, later it was discovered that she was just having pains in her stomach, and they said they wanted to go and check it, and they said it was fibroid, and it was fibroid. Only for them to rush her to the theater, open her up, there was no fibroid. They forgot cotton wool in her stomach about 2 years ago. That cotton wool had not started having mucus. It was the mucus that was causing her pain. If the mercy of God has not showed up, if God's mercy hasn't showed up, a baby school, a child that is less than 1 year, right? Less than 1 year, was sick, maybe malaria, normal malaria. They took the child to a hospital in this town. A nurse gave the child injection, put the injection to the child's bum bum. The needle broke in the bum bum. The nurse removed the normalcy, left the child, and just packaged the child and gave to the mother. After, is it 2 weeks or this thing? More than a month, the child started crying. Child cannot stand on the leg. Abby cannot walk. Kusha. The child was leaping. Crying and leaping. What is wrong with my child? Why? They took the child to the hospital, did the X-ray, and the X-ray discovered that there is a needle in the child's bum bum. They had to tear the bum bum and bring the needle out. Show me the nurse that did this rubbish. Everybody hide the nurse. I have seen a child that became paralyzed because they gave him injection. If the mercy of the Lord, people you run to for help, at times they are killers. Are you following me at all? They are killers. You just enter car, you say, drive me, take me to Ring Road. If God's mercy does not show up, you know, I heard of people dying inside cab. You drive, you make calls. People have made calls and their phones exploded. Yes. So people, millions have been stolen, defrauded. So people have laid hands, also that you lay hands on people and they are blessed. Some ministers have laid, I know a pastor that laid hands on the lady and the hands are shaking. Needle. The lady just they left the letter and started praying for the hand. The mercy of God. He says, it is by God's mercy that we are not consumed. And the Lord is saying, Bible says, show me, Lord, your mercy and be thou my helper. So you're going to lift your hands up. Help me, Lord!
Help me, Lord!
Where do you need divine help? Specific helps.
Help.
Hold on. A lady in this fellowship, she's still here. She was around. She's not here today now. She had a problem in the office. And one day she just came and cried.
I'm tired.
She was actually weeping. I said, what again?
He said, the thing is too much, it's too much. The PS does not want to hear my name. He just hates me. I said, yeah, call the commissioner now. Call the commissioner. They were classmates. I said, call the commissioner. He said, if I call the commissioner, they wanted to move her away from where she is to a village.
So she knew I don't know what to do. And I said, call the commissioner. He said, yeah, okay. Tell the commissioner, look at what they are trying to do. She called the commissioner. The commissioner said, they actually said about this. I don't, is your name among them? Okay, don't worry, they won't move you. So at the commissioner's desk, he removed their name from it. When the PS saw that, oh my God, he said, we'll deal with you now. They refused to move her to her position where she should be, and then brought some people to be sent, and then moved her from the area she was supervising to another area. Oh, when they moved her, she said, they are moving away from the area I was supervising to that area. It used to be very profitable. I said, the law will make where you are more profitable. Really, I said about that one. But she said, look at what they are planning. They are doing their own. And I said, one day she just came and said, this is not too much. Do you know what to do? He said, no. I said, give 1 month's salary to God. He said, as I came back from Europe last year, I said, give God 1 month's salary. I said, don't fast. Just give God. He said, hey. I said, yes. Can you do that? He said, I go try. You know some of those things. He said, I go try my best. When she gave the 1 month salary, I prayed for her. You know what happened? The guy they brought to our office to come and take our duty, that one is still in the hospital till now, so I talk to you. And the hospital is not in Benin. Correct sickness, all like, bah! Sickness sent him to Irua. The PS are diggity. Sent him away from position. They just removed him from there. Who should they do that? They removed him from that ministry and sent to another ministry. The guy is sad. He brought another one. He said, look at what they have done, though. I said, nah. The one they are bringing shall be for your favor. He said, amen, oh, amen, amen. It is the mercy of God. He said, because I gave, I sold my office. Yes, that was the road that God directed. But many people have given and they are still waiting. Even when what you do for God works, know that mercy, somewhere along the line, mercy showed up. Are you following me at all?
Yes.
But that is mercy. Your prayers cannot be answered. Yes. Every second of the day, you are doing something wrong.
Yes.
Lift your hands up. Help me, Lord.
Help me, Lord.
You have to go specific now. Lord, this is what I am struggling with in life. This is what the problem is. I am struggling with sin. I am struggling with fornication. I am struggling with drugs. I am struggling with getting married. I am struggling with having children. I am struggling with counting millions. Lord, help me, help me, help me, help me. Help me, Lord, help me, help me, help me, help me, help me. Help me, Lord, help me, help me, help me, help me, help me. Jesus, help me. Jesus, help me. Jesus, help me. Jesus, help me. Help me, Lord. 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 In the name of Jesus. 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 This load, carry it, Lord. I want you to ask God for specific things. I want you to ask God for specific things. Help me with my marriage. Help me with this man. Help me here, Father, help me. Help me, Lord. This thing is too much. Help me, Lord. Ikabosha, veregelaya, regedelota, rekepeyaba. By the message of the Lord, where there is restoration, by the message of the Lord, there is restoration. By the message of the Lord, there is love. By God's message, there is peace. By God's message, we are preserved. We are preserved. We are preserved. Are you praying? Are you praying at all? Say, help me, Jesus. Carry my load. Carry my troubles. Carry my setback. Carry my oppressions. Help me, Lord. Carry my troubles. In the name of Jesus, we are going to pray some prayers. Say, Lord Jesus, by your mercy, preserve me. We looked at that earlier. Preserve me. Restore me. Help me. Validate my life. By your mercy. I want you to call on God's mercy to do this thing. I want to give you opportunity today. This thing is what you are going to be your testimony. You will pick on three things and ask that God's mercy should intervene. Take the best seed you can take right now and hold it in your hands quickly. If you want to write check, you write check. Take the best seed you can take now. You are going to lift it up and say, Father, I want to see your help in this area. Let me see value here. Let me see restoration here. Let me see divine help here. You know, I'm giving you 3 minutes, no? 2 minutes to do this. You are going to start. Father, in the name of Jesus, help me here. Help me here. Help me here. Help me for this. Lord, show me mercy. Can you just go ahead? Show me mercy. Lord, 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 show me mercy. In the name of Jesus, let your mercy speak for me. To God, come on, call God on that situation. Call God on that situation. Show me mercy. Ah, Lord, 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 show me mercy. Show me mercy. Show me mercy. Show me mercy. Raka papa papa papa. Raka papa papa papa. Ragagagagagagagaga. Zogodogodogo ragada. Eko zakapayada. Ego. Iko barita barado shata. Zoko balanda kamanda kuriya bakasha. Eko bakataya. Eko domajata. Eko baradanasho. Zoko domata. Eko koko toloyo. Kobra kata zadosh. Koba kata koko bray. Mengro dosh kopaya. Godo do do do. Godo do 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 do. Do 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 do. Do bakaba shotoya. Oh Jesus, lift your hand up. Father, I receive mercy. I receive mercy. I receive help.
I receive help.
I receive value.
I receive value.
I receive restoration.
I receive restoration.
I receive help.
I receive help.
I receive value.
I receive value.
I receive restoration.
I receive restoration.
Father,
Father,
I receive love.
I receive love.
I receive favor.
I receive favor.
By your work of mercy.
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 In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Let the ushers go round. Sit down. Watch it. Three things that can stop the mercy of God. You know, this morning, God showed somebody in the United States mercy. When our broadcast here is spreading, amen? We're having viewers, we're having views from different continents and nations of the world. So whenever we're in service here, we are more than how we are here. Praise God. From India, from Pakistan, are following and they get in touch. Last night at about 11, somebody sent me a message and it's on WhatsApp. I'm trying to reach her now. He said, "Hello, how are you? Thank you for feeding my spirit, man. God bless you." And I get WhatsApp messages like that, international calls, and I ask them, "How did you get to know us?" He said, "I watched you on YouTube, I watched you on Facebook and all that." So this particular one, I called this morning. I discovered that she's in Chicago, US. And she was actually on a wheelchair. That the doctors have operated on her legs twice. And twice they made a mistake. And so Ibo doctor, they make mistake. On her knees. On her kneecap. So they did one. The first one made one error. She went to the hospital to correct that error. The other one made another error. She also landed on wheelchairs. Praise God. Says she's been watching our services. You know, I don't normally just look at the comments on Facebook because there are a lot of comments. Amen. So at times when they reach me on WhatsApp, I know this person has copied the number from the screen and is going personal. I ask her, "What church do you attend?" And she said she just stopped her church recently that pastors are now dubious and all this kind of stuff. You are alive, right? Praise God. And then he said, "Please, man of God, can you pray for my legs? It seems hurting, it's feeling bad, pains." I said, "Let's pray." And we prayed. I was just praying in tongues and we commanded the power of God. Praise God. And I said, "Madam, can you stand up and walk around?" And I was there, "Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus." I said, "What's that?" He said, "Now I'm bending down, I'm walking, I'm doing this." I said, "Sure." We spoke for more than 1 hour. "Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I'm bending my knees. I'm standing up. I'm walking. Do you feel better?" "Yeah, I feel better. I feel better. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you." And I actually told her that we're going to pray for her from the service today. I told her to get communion materials, but I've called her several in and I think she's not picking. Let's give the Lord a clap for that. Lift your hands and just pray for her. We pray for Sister Carol in the name of Jesus. Lord, extend your hand to her in Chicago, USA. Her healing is permanent. We command that she will not be in wheelchairs again. In the name of Jesus. The power of the Holy Ghost, Carol. The life of God imparted into you. The strength of God imparted into you. In the name of Jesus. And we command that God shall give you joy. God shall give you peace. God shall give you soundness. God shall give you favor. Sister Carol, God shall give you strength. And your remaining days shall be happy on earth. In the name of Jesus. Give the Lord another clap. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Somebody say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. I'm actually getting ready for a service that will go to bring life to people, different nations, commanding the healing power. And God is just going to be working. And you know, in 2 weeks' time, there's going to be miracles everywhere in this place. MMWA Holy Ghost Experience on the 17th, Thursday morning, 9 a.m., Friday, 9 p.m., all night, Saturday, 2 p.m., and Sunday, 4 p.m. Those 4 days are going to be days that God's miracle power, this place will be overfilled, so there will be a canopy and out overflowing outside and the television outside. Power of God will be walking here and walking outside and walking everywhere. And also, blessed are the merciful. Blessed are the merciful. The mercy of God gives you value. The mercy of God gives you restoration. The mercy of God sends you love and peace. Peace comes to your life by God's mercy. The mercy of God also gives you what? It helps you. Are you following me? Now, how do I receive this mercy? He said, unto you become merciful. How do we explain you becoming merciful? We looked at it for like two weekends now, until you begin to show love to others. Are you following me? The summary of you being merciful is you being loving. Somebody say, I be loving. And we looked at it yesterday. The Bible says God is love. And so I should be love because I am godly. Praise God. You, without love, you cannot show God. Whatsoever is not love is not of God. And we established over the weeks that, watch me, that unbelievers cannot love. A man, a boy, a woman, a girl who is not born again cannot love. They can like. They can be attracted, but they can't love. Love is not an attraction. Love is a commitment. Love is a decision. I decide to help you to be better. That is love. I decide to push your life forward. That is love. Love is a commitment to help somebody to a better place. That was why. Now, love is in spite of the person. Most of the times when the world loves, they see a curvy lady, they love her. They see a well-spoken man, they love him. They see a rich guy, they love him. That is not love. That is, I like him, I'm attracted. Trust me, when you like, it's because of what the person has done, what the person represents. When you are attracted, it's because of what you see. But when you love, it has nothing to do with what you see. In fact, love, why we were yet sinners? Because so love is an attribute that does not wait for who the person is. In other words, and I say, who do you love? All. Who do you love? All. Even the guy that raped your younger sister, love him. Why? Because without love, you are not God. You are not godly. Bible says, he that has no love does not know God. Are you following this? All this we have looked at them, right? Come on now. Have we not looked at all these scriptures? He that loveth not, knoweth not God. That's what the Bible says. So to know God, one of the proofs that you know God, one of the proof that you know God is that you love men. True of us. Are you following me at all? Are you getting this? One of the proofs. If you love men because they love you, what thank have you? So we say that for every love you love, God will thank you. There is a divine thank you for loving. Are you following me at all? And for before you can receive a thank you, it is not when you love those that love you. Loving those that love you is good because you are meant to love all, including those that doesn't love you. The Bible says there is no fear in love. In other words, you don't love fearfully. You don't love somebody and you are careful about the person. When I say you love and you are suspecting the person, no. Love is plain. Love is transparent. That is the love of God. Hello. We looked at all this. And Bible says, we should love the world as he loved us. And he now says, love makes one what? Perfect. There is perfection in what? Now, when I said that love is a perfecter. Love is a what? It's a perfecter. He now says, and as he is, so are we in this world. Why? Because when you love the way he loves, you become the way he is. And we said so many other things. Are you following me at all? He said that if you pray days and pray in tongues and fast for 50 days, okay, are there 10,000? Okay, today I'm going to preach powerfully. No! Praise the name of the Lord. It is walking in love. Trouble. You that have heard them, you are the one in trouble. Because for everyone you have refused to forgive, you have locked up your own life in prison. The offense will surely come. You will do it again, though. But I forgive you in advance. As I forgive the one you have done, and I forgive you for the one you will still do. You will still do. I have forgiven you. So anything you do it, I say, okay, forgive me. Don't cancel. I know that you will do this before. Are you following me? I say, I will never do it. Yes. And keep my commandments. Do you see that? Showing mercy unto what? Thousands of them. Read it. That love me and keep my commandments. Now, you know what the Lord said? I think we looked at it yesterday for those people that were around. Many of them are not around now, but some of you were not around yesterday. For those that came yesterday, what do you look at? The Bible says that, if you love me, keep my commandments. What is my commandment? He said, this is the commandment. What? That you love one another. This is the commandment. So watch. He said, and showing mercy unto thousands of them that love me and keep my commandments. See that? He said, you see my mercy. I show you mercy when you love me. How do you love me? Love one another.